Overtime, why not?
Yeah, super sick.
I mean, look, the obvious choice is Astralis. They were incredible in group stages, and they are a better team than Dignitas. So, I mean, there's no reasonable, there's no good reason to pick Dignitas. Otherwise, other than just to say that you've done it, so which is good enough for me. So, you know, go with Dignitas, why not?
Yeah, Kerrigan isn't going to make the same kinds of mistakes that he's made in the past versus other Danish teams. Fragbite Masters, SK come to mind. Not going to happen this time, I'm pretty sure. So, I mean, we can kind of favor Astralis. And look at this, man. Astralis just spread out all across this map. Flat default. No early aggression coming out from them whatsoever. Both teams actually just sitting and waiting for their opponents to make the first move.
Very, very laid-back style coming out of the terrorist side here. Really almost a little bit nervous, I look. It looks like, from Astralis. Worried about Dignitas moving somewhere. And, of course, these being domestic teams, it's going to be a little bit scary. They will know each other quite well. Nobody from Dignitas is doing anything special either. They do have a strong, really strong mid presence and are essentially playing the A bomb side as a retake, with which they just have the one smoke and a kit on Tensky as well. So things could get just a little bit tricky, but that one smoke is definitely going to help out. It's going to help out block out a lot of main in case any T's are left there for once the defuse goes or the bomb is down. So see if it's going to work out or not. KRB putting in a couple of shots. They are on the bomb side and putting the bomb down, and it will be a default plant. So both Kerrigan and Cajun are going to be a little bit obsolete if that smoke ever gets put up. But right now, Dignitas are going to have a fight on their hands to try and retake. Because no one has died yet, and the bomb is down.
This is crazy, and Dignitas are practically on the doorstep of A side already. Four guys, soon to be five, all coming in from CT and short. This is going to be a great rush down coming in from them, and Kerrigan, he has to haul ass to get in here to have an impact, because otherwise this team is just going to get overwhelmed. Device and Cajun do pick up kills, and there we go. Kerrigan has his say as well, but it doesn't matter. The smoke defuse. How sick was that?
Tensky, he was in that smoke. Oh, yeah, I did point it out. The one smoke and the kit, and because they had the default plan, it's become my new pet hate. I'm going to have to point this out every single time. I've already done it for a long time now, but this is my new pet hate. I had it on Inferno when people planted it on the A bomb site, inside the bomb site behind the sort of the main box there,
right,
and then ended up putting one terrorist in an apartment. I hate when people do that. I still hate when people do that on Inferno. On this map, it has to be the default A plant like that. It's so often, it just comes down to the people in main not being able to do a single thing. It's so hard for people to do anything in that position.
It's a mad tilt, though, coming in. I mean, Cajun, he's clearly pissed off. He goes in, rips MSL's head off. Dupree will find the duel, and well, okay, then Astralis still looking to rectify things. They aren't wasting any time at all. That was a fluke in the pistol round, apparently, because Astralis went for the force buy, and they're just annihilating Dignitas in this round. Talk about, like, the huge come down that's about to happen for Dignitas. Tensky? Well, let's hear. Yeah, it's Kerrigan going for it this time.
Of course it is.
Not a peep out of Dignitas.
I like what you did as well. Rectify? Is that a real pun?
Can we actually go for that?
Of course we can. It's going to tie the scoreline up at 1-1 and moving into the third round. Well, Dignitas respond with four Deagles and a single C-set 75 of Rubino with a single flashbang, which I kind of wish that they were going for a bit of an NA main peak there. Still could be a choice for them if they end up there. Rubino's going to be going down, so no flashes are going to be thrown. And a lot of mid control here for Astralis. Cajun picking up a couple of kills early on. Konvik and Tensky left.
And all their own, some, I mean, each on one site, so I mean, hopefully they can actually pick up one kill, but it's about to get hot here for Konvik. There's going to come barreling through the vents, and he doesn't have necessarily the best gun to deal with this. C's head maybe would have been pretty solid. Tensky will find a headshot with the Deagle on the other side of the map against Device, picks up a P90, but that's of little value to him in the end. Doesn't really matter. But yeah, that was a bit rough for Konvik. Deagle, they're just coming pouring out of those vents. You're just going to lose control of the situation so quickly there. So, Astralis, just getting work done at this point. They're looking so comfortable right now. Not really sure how this is going to pan out, seeing as how, well, it's another round of eco. Hard eco this time for Dignitas. So Astralis just getting more time to farm up money. Device even going so far as to pick up an MP7 in this round just to make some bonus SMG money. And while Astralis T-side cash is looking, it's just looking really solid. This is right, Anders. I mean, what you're saying at the beginning of this match, where they aren't going to make any mistakes. They're just going to get in here and do work. Astralis is the group phase after all, and they should be feeling confidence against Dignitas. Once you have that edge, they're just not showing any respect whatsoever.
And Dignitas could feel that on the other side. You have to believe that's a great grenade. Konvik trying to hide in the corner behind the box. Not going to make it out alive. Tensky goes down. And Rubino last alive. Trying to see if he could make any kind of an impact all around here. Jumping around the corner, maybe not the best start, but either way, no armor. They didn't get to save the P90 from the last round either, so not much of an impact being had. Now they are able to buy. It's not going to be any kind of AWP here you have to expect, and very limited grenades. And they have smokes and everything. They don't have any Molotovs. And they've got no defuse kit currently picked up. So we'll make a note of that at the beginning of the round and hope that doesn't come back to haunt them later on. Sometimes does.
Oh, we need a couple of these players to start waking up here as well. Several of them, in fact. Config, Rubino, and Kirby. None of them have picked up a kill yet. Only two kills picked up total for Dignitas so far in this first half. Which is basically why Astralis are all filthy rich at this point. Mad money across the board for Astralis going into the fifth round here. So Dignitas with the rifles. They have plenty of flashes still. So we'll see when they decide to use them. And they are trying to change things up a little bit, as you guys can see with the boost happening on that A site. Trying to find a little bit of an off angle. Stacking up one on top of the other as well, which is clever. Sometimes you can try and cheat if you're T side. You know, you can try and cheat around an A main. Look for an angle to work. There's two rifles ready there to face them. So this is nice from Dignitas. Just a little adjustment that could actually pay off.
Still got the bomb just now being picked up by Dupree, and they're actually made their way back towards the B bomb site. So Sip might be left alone at Squeak, but Kerrigan, I assume, is going to be falling back, maybe after making a bit of noise. But this could be a really good push. MSL and Config are going to have a bit of a hard time defending each other if they are sort of lined up in the B bomb site like they are down there. And Kerrigan making some noise. Smoke goes in. Squeak doors open. Grenades are out as well. Is anyone rotating in? They got three men there, but still two at B. So they're not quite buying a Dignitas just yet. See if they can actually make this work. Nice shot from Sip. Going to be taking one down, but that kill on MSL, that's the essential one. Now all alone in the A-bomb site. It's going to be Tensky up there. And the rest pushing into B right now. Config with a great kill at the edge of the smoke. Dupree wants to get the bomb down, but he's got no backup. And Config, well, just going to be walking in. Tensky ultimately getting the kill on Sip as well, and it's a 1-on-3 here. Device alone goes down. Config with a great triple kill, essentially single-handedly defending that B-bomb site after the distraction at A works quite well. I mean, as soon as Kerrigan picks up a kill in that bomb site, it's really, really hard for Dignitas to know what's happening.
As Kirby, actually, who made all the difference on that A site, the fact that he was boosted meant that he saw over all the smokes. He's like, I don't see anybody coming to this site, boys, so just stay solid on the B site. No over-rotation happened early on for Dignitas. And then, yeah, obviously, the individual play coming in from Config made all the difference. Curious to see why Dupree would go for the plant like that. I guess he is expecting Config to play, you know, air quotes, smart, which is, you know, you get the first kill, you back off into CT, and then you wait for the rotation to come in from your mates, and you play as a team. Instead, Config just decided to play, you know, play the game his own way. Took control of the situation single-handedly. And a very quick round coming in here from Astralis, but Kierby and Rubino holding the line. Zipnix and Squeak will pick up the kill on Kierby, but damage is done. It's a 2-on-4 now. Astralis way behind now in the round.
Cajun needs to do some real damage here, but he's just going to get that peek by Config, coming in at a good angle there. And Kirby picking up two kills early on here. That's going to tie up the scoreline, and suddenly the sort of the confidence and the style that was being shown from Astralis earlier on, it seems to just fall flat right here. Dignitas suddenly coming back into the game with a lot of strength here. And I mean, these two teams have a history. These two sort of lineups have had a history of playing each other. Some really, really close games. But it always seems to be, always seems to be Astralis coming out on top.
Yeah, when it's Dane on Dane, it's always very close. Just because both of these in-game leaders are going to be very familiar, they'll have studied each other a lot. MSL maybe a little bit even more than Kerrigan has studied MSL, right? Just because when you're the underdog, you're looking to find every little edge you can to, well, unseat the kings, the current kings of Denmark. And so MSL, you know, it's going to come down to Kerrigan thinking quickly on his feet, and more importantly, it's going to come down to his teammates listening to his calls. They have to be able to just follow through. They can't, you know, start overthinking things. As soon as Kerrigan calls for something, they have to react immediately and actually go in to get the job done. But Dignitas, they're just like completely spread out across this map right now. Straight line across the board. Two guys holding on short as well, which is interesting. So if that A play does come through, there will be an extra man who's able to rotate over very quickly to support.
Not necessarily a bad setup. I mean, it does mean limited control in middle, which it seems like Astralis are going to end up abusing. And as a result, as a response to that loss of mid control, they're now peeking into A main. It was a very good idea. Look how much information they're getting. They're realizing nobody's here. They're going to see the sandwich coming. It's coming in from Squeak, and that's going to be the early kill. Dupree taking down Rubino as well, and that's the whole bomb site gone. So it's a great choice and a great couple of kills coming back here. Tensky and Rubino picking it up. And Kirby, sorry, helping out with two of them there. MSL going down, and now Config in a 1-on-3. And the bomb is planted as well. And it's going to be very hard for him to clutch it this time.
What a chaotic situation. Two players in A main. Astralis never expected the second man to be in there, and Kirby definitely took advantage of the situation. His teammates, however, just not able to capitalize off of that play. Config takes a bullet to the face from Dupree, who was holding by quad. And that's going to be 4-3 now. Astralis right back in this. Couple of bumpy rounds there where Dignitas started to, you know, look a bit better in their game. And Astralis with a very clean round in the end, just come right through.
Essentially, they had sort of was a one piece of the puzzle, but they needed another one, right? They push into main and they see no one is there.
Yeah.
So then if you see no one middle, you're thinking it's a B push, right? But they push into main, they don't know anyone, and as they fall back to get more information, they get shot by Sip, and then they come out of highway and they realize, oh wait, it's an A hit instead.
That's the key kill right there, right? Zip makes and Squeak. If he dies, then it gets really awkward for Astralis. Config crouching behind the box is going to completely catch him out. Now Dupree, he's so low on HP, but somehow Config decides to take the fight in the Molotov, and he was so low on HP, just roasts. Easy kill there for Device. Catches Kirby out on short. Well, Astralis did look a little dicey in the B halls for a moment there, but they will be able to stabilize, although MSL has picked up that AK, so there is a rifle on the board here for Dignitas to work with.
Oh, this is so bad news for Dignitas. They really can't afford to give Astralis this kind of a lead, but they don't really have much choice given the weaponry they have right now. Rubino trying to make it work with the Deagle, and he's going to end up getting a kill on Kerrigan. Backup is a little bit slow here. Rubino actually got someone isolated in the corner. That Sip going down, and now it's a 2-on-2. Device going to be picking up that kill. Another Molotov in the back line there, but not quite going to hit. A little bit scary. Still walks out and actually does get tagged through the side of the box. They don't have a lot of health on the Dignitas side, but if they win this round, that would be a huge boost to their confidence.
Oh, they know the Device is close now behind Yellow. So MSL holding that angle with the AK. All he has to do is get the tag, but no, Device steps out. Headshot with the AWP, and now it's all on Tenski. He does pick up that AK. That was spotted by Device. But this should just be Device controlling the situation. Bomb has been picked up by Dupree as well as the security to head over towards the B site in the end. But Device doesn't need any help. Gets the job done on his own. Had a very scary round there. That was a hard eco coming out from Dignitas pretty much. Just a little bit of money spent on them by the guys who had a load in the bank. But Astralis to drop three players like that and cut it so close, that doesn't bode well.
No, and it was confusing because Sip was so far into, well, he was trapped in the corner. But they started pushing in, and then Kerrigan was the first man in, and everyone else was so far behind him, there was no real follow-up. So a bit of a mistake maybe, a bit of miscommunication.
Finally. Oh, run boost on A site from Tenski.
Ah, good news. I mean, except for the man that is looking like a B execute. Other than that.
It's a shame, I'm curious. I don't think Zipnix was close enough to hear it either. So no additional information to go off of there for Astralis, but you're right. It does look like they're just setting up for the big play to go here onto the B side of Cash.
Still just two people on it. MSL setting up for the flashbang, gonna come in. It lines up one as he realized the second one in the smoke. Great job from MSL getting both those kills. Hasn't been too active in the game so far. Looking for a third as well, almost gets it. A lot of damage being put into Kerrigan. Then Config to follow it up with a kill, and that's gonna buy so much time for the rotation to come in already through the vents. And Astralis in a lot of trouble in this round. Dignitas with some really tight defense. And just the captain here, all on his own, making it work. Sip, it's gonna kill him in return. It shouldn't be enough to change the outcome of this round. They are more or less boxed in still.
Especially with the two players in mid. They can't exactly back off from this situation either. But basically the two players you want to have alive here for this kind of situation for Astralis, Zipnix, Ice Cold, and Device. Of course, with that AWP, clutch player, boom, hits the shot. Config is down. Now he has to realize that there's a man in the vents. He might get backstabbed here. 15 seconds left on this clock. Not a lot of time here to play with. And only two flashes to make life easier for Astralis. Rubino and Tenski both doubling up on Zipnix. And with 9 seconds left, just no hope, Device. How do they end up getting bogged down? So, I mean, did they lose track of how much time they had to play with their Astralis? Because it really did look like they were taking, like they felt like they had a little bit more time to work with there in the end.
It's probably one of those things where you're thinking, we really have to hope that they're gonna push us, you know? Because if one of them pushes, if Rubina pushes out at, you know, 15, then maybe they can make it a 2-on-1 or something. I think it's just hoping that it works out. Not many options for them in that position, but still, I mean, they made it expensive, which still counts. 4-5, even at the bomb plant, they go for the force up here, and a bit of an interesting boost on top of the ice cream truck here, all the way in the back lines. They can see if anyone's in there, but not any real mid control for Dignitas here, which they lost a round to this earlier, so you gotta sort of take notice and see how many times they're gonna give up that mid control. Fantastic flashbang, and they knew MSL must have been there last time. This time they're gonna try and go for him, but he doesn't care, just manages to get both the kills. Device going to be taken on Kirby. And now 3 versus 4, looking very good for Dignitas once again. If they could take this round, they'd force the eco on Astralis and they'd start to build just a little bit of space for themselves on the CT side here.
And that's the kind of play that might slightly tilt Astralis as well. because Cajun did try to do the right thing. He did try to get in there behind Dupree to get the refrag, but failing when, I mean, not only does Dupree get caught full blind with MSL, where MSL is just fully blind, spraying, praying, and he actually gets the kill on Dupree, but then Cajun not getting the refrag, that's going to be very frustrating for Astralis because they feel like, or they should feel like they played that situation correctly. So that's just one of those things you kind of have to shrug, shake it off, and we'll see if Device can actually find a shot here. He does get a tag. No, not the tag, but he does actually spot the man out in Link. And it is going to be Astralis eventually winding up on this A site, but Dignitas is ready and waiting for him. This should be a decent situation here for the defense.
Oh, but that opening shot is going to change everything, isn't it? Device ends up getting the kill on Tenski and very low on health. Rubino in sight. Device misses the shot. Config was quite far away in the rotation. There's Kerrigan picking up a kill. And now it's a one-on-two. He's trying to plant right behind Rubino, who's up on the box and ends up taking him down. So pretty good job from Rubino actually staying alive there. But as soon as Device got that kill in the back line, it was looking a little bit scary for a moment there. It's essentially a three-on-one in that A-bomb site.
Yeah, just way too much. So a little bit of a chat happening there. You can see Kerrigan, Device, having a bit of a back and forth, trying to figure out what they need to do. But this has actually finally put a stop to the Astralis buy train. They had such good money after the, you know, going into the fifth round at the beginning of the half. And ever since, it's been, you know, just mixed buys from them, not letting up the pressure on Dignitas. Finally, Dignitas have a chance to actually get a bank rolling for themselves. 11th round of this half, tied 5-5. Now Dignitas are the ones with the rifles. MSL has the AWP. Even though he's been doing well with the M4, it seems like he wants to go for the sniper rifle. Tenski holding his ground, and well, it's just completely falling apart for Astralis in this round. Nothing achieved for them. Just a little bit of damage to Tenski, not even close to getting a bomb plant.
We should point out that Astralis are almost legendary for having really, really good T sites on this map, and then sort of fairly questionable CT sites. So even if they're at 5-6, which I'm right now, if you just joined the game, pretty good scoreline for the Astralis team. But I would say even if they get like 9 rounds on this first half, I still don't think. I mean, I still won't call it. They've proven so many times that they end up making some strange mistakes once they play CT side.
This is all going to come down to the mental game, and it's almost going to balance itself out, right? Astralis, when they struggle, that's when you really see the faults in their game, where they start to hesitate on their plays, not really follow through. And Dignitas, I mean, they are going to have a little bit of a pressure just because they are facing, you know, the favored team. They are going up against Astralis, who are basically the top dogs in Denmark right now. So we'll see how they actually adjust to that as they do finally decide to take over mid here, Astralis. So once again, getting two players out here, and this actually sets them up for the split onto A. But again, three players waiting there for Dignitas, and Dignitas again pushing into A main. So the same trap has been set here for Astralis. We have to see if they actually walk into it, and if Dignitas are going to be able to play correctly this time. They aren't peeking, and Config taking out the man in mid is going to make a big difference.
Yeah, counter boosted up into vent. Very good response now. Kerrigan trying to see if he could make it out of the round, but not going to happen. Gets taken down by Kiebu, and this time, instead of, because what they did last time is they pushed into main and then they sort of instantly ran back and got caught in the door. This time they said, well, we'll just take up camp here. Just wait. If you do come up highway and out there, we'll shoot you in the back and try and see if we can make that work. So they did sort of almost the same thing, but then they made a slight adjustment at the end, trying to learn from their mistakes. And then the counter boost from Config coming out was really good as well. So 7-5, and yeah, Dignitas, I think, they're showing us a lot right now.
They're showing us the resolve to get the job done. MSL catch Cajun peeking over in B halls, and now Astralis again just gathered up. This is an eco from them, although there is a little bit of an investment going into it. Kevlar picked up on Dupree and Kerrigan, so they can take a little bit more of a fight. Kerrigan always good with that Tech 9, and while Dupree with the Deeg, we've seen him do magical things in the past, so he has to turn up here if Astralis wants to actually have a chance of getting a bomb plant here in this round. So they can move up short, and that's actually Dupree. He's going to be able to get the spot onto the man in quad. Tag goes out onto Tenski, and now they know what's up here. Dignitas, the push is going to come in on the A site, and Device up close with the CZ just sprays down Kierby.
Yeah, completely flashed for a moment there, Kierby. Tenski in the back line, pistols out as well. And then going down to Kerrigan. A little bit of a dicey situation here, back into a 2-on-2. Bomb is being picked up, and Astralis is going to go for the default plant, which can't really fault them for. They don't have a lot of control right now. So hard for them to try and plant in the open corner. Config and Rubino, who's coming in from highway, going to see if they can make some space for each other here. Grid peek coming out, and Config going to get that kill all on Device, and he has no armor, so this is a really tough fight for him to try and take. Gets the first kill, but walks right into Config's shot. And that'll be the round 8-5 here, favoring Dignitas. And that's going to be a fifth round in a row for them as well.
What is happening here? Is Config trolling them? Oh, he swapped out for a Deagle, and he gets an AK. because he kept tapping the bomb like he was going to fake the fuse it or something like that, and he kept coming off of the defuse as well. Usually when you do that, for all those who, you know, all those of you who have played matchmaking, you know what's up. Just like tap, 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 tap. Yeah. Okay, we get it. You won the round.
I've got either that or someone was trying to communicate some really stupid message to him on the team, saying like, pick up the other weapon, no, the other one, it's in that corner. You know, stuff like that. Hopefully not at this level. 14th round coming up, and we'll see if Astralis can get back here with a couple of rounds. I think 5 is, it's doable, but it's cutting it a bit close, actually.
Yeah, it is not. This isn't good enough. They need the last 2 rounds in this half, Astralis. You want to finish 8-7 minimum if you're on the T side. So they really do need to actually, you know, come alive here, Astralis, and start, you know, landing the shots. And so far, again, they just kind of go for the default. Again, with the boost, device into mid with that AWP, hoping to catch somebody out. But again, Dignitas, all they do really is play a man on Sugar Cube. They're not really putting anybody behind the sandbags. There have been a few peaks in Link, but that's later on in the round. And we're about to get there eventually here. We're down to a minute. So around 50 seconds, you could actually see that peak happen. So that maybe that is what device is waiting for. But it is going to be Dupree moving in on Garage. Gets the vents cleared out. And they're being very thorough, at least, Astralis. Taking their time with this.
Again, that loss of mid control for Dignitas, which you can obviously tell is a deliberate choice here. They're really deciding not to fight it. But it gives Astralis so much space to work with. MSL, though, with an important kill here. We'll see if they're going to make it work. I'm very doubtful of giving up this much mid control on Cash on the CT side. It always worries me. But they have had some good rounds behind it, so you can't really question it too much either. Config getting caught out in the open here. Wanted to make it onto the site, but Dupree was there in checkered through the vents from middle. And Sip sitting up right by the ramp, not being spotted either. MSL going to go down. Quick trade there as Device dies. And Rubino shot in the face. Sitnik showing up for the party and is going to get 2 kills for it. Kevin and Tensky going to have to go for a bit of a dangerous retake here. But in the 14th round, I think they have some money in the bank as well. They should try and see if they can't get an early kill here and maybe make it work. That grenade almost doing the job, but not quite. Kirby making it out onto upper right now, just looking for the one opening, but he's going to get caught. That's a great angle. And Sip finding a 3rd kill of the round for himself. Tensky still wanting to risk it. A little bit scary at this point, and he's going to end up falling back.
Well, this might be a good round for the Weatherman to take a look at later on, because what actually prompted Dignitas to go for the hard rotate off that B site is they were making the correct call. They had 3 players on B just waiting. And then right before Astralis decided to come into the site, boom, they all start rotating off. And that's why Config is caught completely out of position. He gets his smoke down, but then he's not able to get onto the site because the man was already in checkered. You know, what actually told MSL, this is going to be an A play, and we need to actually rotate over to A immediately here, despite the fact that we had the correct setup to deal with the Astralis push.
Yeah, that's a good question. I mean, the other, I guess, another answer to that is also to say, well, when they don't have mid control, it is very hard for them to know exactly what's happening, right? It's hard for them to get a lot of information to make any kind of a call on. So we will see. 6-8, and moving into the last round of the half, we got 2 AWPs in play on Astralis' side. Device and Kerrigan in charge of that mess for a moment. And almost could have been an opening kill there. Look at the push out of B, though, and that's beautiful play from Dignitas here. Something they haven't tried before. And you can see how badly that caught Cajun off guard.
Yeah, Cajun is just going to be cursing his luck. He's just repeatedly losing the duel round after round over in B Halls. It's just not making it any easier for his teammates. Unlucky for Config there. He does get spotted just before he gets into position by Device. So no element of surprise for him. Device hunts him down. Nice flash into A main, though. And there's the big punish. Can't be. No time wasted at all from Dignitas. As soon as they lose control of mid, bam, they go for the flash into main. They look to get it back, and they actually maintain the man advantage here. So Astralis, the pressure is ratcheting up on them. They really need this 15th round.
3 vs 4, it's not impossible, especially with Dupree being that far up into the middle. That gives them a point to rotate around on the map, but 40 seconds means they have to commit at some point here. Maybe with that smoke going up, sneaking on through the edge, but MSL's still a bit quicker than Device. But you got to wonder how that works out. He certainly had the better angle for it. Just not quick enough. Kirby going to be going down. Blind spray from Sip, who's very low on health, and Dupree doesn't have a lot more either. At least he's on the bomb site, putting the bomb down for Dupree's position. So some basic Counter-Strike coming out right now. But look at the health on Dignitas. If they can't win these 2 fights, then, well, just the 1 fight now. Dupree all on his own, and he's being flanked as well. Has no idea, and that's going to be the round. A 9-6 favoring Team Dignitas here at the end of the first half. Pretty good scoreline for them, I think. I think they're going to be excited about this.
This is really good job. I mean, really good work coming out from the second Danish team, basically. And I'm glad to see that they aren't actually, I mean, after obviously the strong start that they had, right, winning the pistol, all the shouting, Kerrigan wins the second round, shouts right back. Dignitas calm down after that, right? They get a key round. They finish the half 9-6, which is an excellent score for them. They don't get too high. They don't get overhyped. They know that they still have a lot of work ahead of them to get this map under their belts and get that first seed coming out of the group. So apparently MSL is requesting a bathroom break real quick. So maybe we might have a longer wait here. Not sure. We'll see what the admin ruling is. He might be able to take a timeout. Seems like he actually wants to use the timeout.
Tactical timeout.
It is the tactical timeout. So actually, this is good to note. So tactical timeout for Dignitas has been used in this second half. So if they struggle at all on this T side, they might not have that timeout.
For 2 minutes.
It doesn't look like MSL actually believes in that old technique, right? The land technique where it's like, okay, you know, you chug a bottle of water before you match because you, before your match, because if you have to use the restroom for the entire match, you focus better, right? If you have to take a piss, you know, it's just like zones your mind in. Maybe it was just too much MSL, you know, it was getting to the point where he just couldn't handle it. Pressure in the game, pressure in the body. Just, you know, too much pressure, Anders.
Thing is, I mean, I don't know how that works. I don't know what the justification for it would be.
I honestly wonder as well, but...
It sounds like some placebo bullshit.
It's all about the mind stuff, man. So I like that Device is taking advantage of MSL's tactical timeout as well. He's like, fine. You gonna use your timeout? Great. Sounds good to me. They're all ran over to the restroom. So maybe a little bit of a powwow. Maybe we should send an admin over there to make sure that Device doesn't get jumped by Tenski. I think Tenski went as well.
It's an interesting way to win a match, surely.
Oh, no. He slipped and fell. His wrist.
Well, I mean, I don't know what to say at this point. I think the word, what they're saying in the chat is basically that he drank a whole liter of Monster before he went live MSL, so maybe that's the reason.
I don't know how you play like that, though,
leader
man.
Liter of Coke? Like, anyone watched Super Cola. Troopers? Liter of Cola.
Yeah, Liter of Cola. Excellent movie. Snozberries taste like snozberries.
It's a really, really good movie. I've rewatched it a couple of times, like, years later, thinking I'm probably not going to find this fun anymore because it was like, you know, it's like some juvenile film, but it still is pretty funny.
Dude, of course it is. And you know, when like Sadokist is like driving around road tripping in Germany, going from like land to land, he gets a Porsche and everything. I'm just picturing him as that, like that older German guy with the Porsche and Super Troopers. Wow, wow. You know, just like gets pulled over. What's the matter, officer?
Yeah, I could see that happening as well. I could see Sadokist trying to flirt with a policeman to get out of it. That could very well happen. I think we are back into the game now. We've got the bathroom break out of the way, and we've got Dignitas and Astralis playing each other. Rest of one game here. The winner's match. So they're going to go on to the quarterfinals if they win here. Otherwise, they're going to be playing Nip in a best of three. Imagine if Nip have to play Astralis in a best of three. That would be shocking. It'd be upsetting for Nip as well. Worst possible lock. There almost be like some sort of like historic justice to it, because that's what happened to this Astralis lineup way back in the day when Nip were the ultimate team. They would always run into Nip every single time in the semis or quarters. So there we go.
And then like ultimate frustration, yeah. Ah, the times have changed. The tables have turned, Anders. Nip, that is definitely worse than I mean, actually, it's kind of frustrating. It must be a little bit frustrating for Nip right now, because it's actually like they're watching this match right now. They're just saying, crap, like both of these teams are actually pretty good. Like, what are you thinking when you're going into this?
Well,
gonna be a bit of a tough match for them. Either way it breaks at this point. But Dignitas on the T side now, swapped over. That's it. They're done. They've relieved themselves, and now let's see if they can get the job done in the second half. And we have the raid boss, double raid boss, actually coming out here for Dignitas.
Something we started to see more and more recently. We got two smokes as well to set it up for a bit of an A push here, and there's Sipnix and Kerrigan and Cajun. Device not that far away. It's a pretty strong setup here at the A bomb site, but still, if you get close with the Tech Nines here, the CT pistols are simply going to run out of ammo if you don't get quick headshots, so it's going to be dangerous anyway. Cajun picking up the first shot there, killing MSL. Sip actually lands that one click, dodging him behind the box, and now he's just playing ring around the rosy Cajun there to help out. Tenski going to be going down. A fantastic defense being put up by Astralis, and Rubino all alone now, 1-on-4. There's not much that he could do at this point. I mean, I don't know what the best case scenario is.
Just another masterful performance from the Maestro himself, Anders. Zipmix.
Wow.
So sick in the pistols.
Yeah, that I mean, that kill he got when he on highway, that was incredible. That was just a pixel, well, sort of a, I guess a line row, very tight angles, what I'm trying to say. Let's look at this.
It. Just like, boom.
That's actually away. Ridiculous.
Wins the duel versus Kierby. Kierby's going to be kicking himself, especially because he had the drop on Zipmix. For a split second there, Zipmix is still trying to adjust his aim. So that's not the start that Dignitas were looking for, unfortunately for them. But instead of going for the full buy, they actually prioritize. They go Deagle, Kevlar. Like, no Deagles. I mean, no Kevlar, rather. Full Deagles across the board. Not a single Tech 9 for Dignitas. Not a single nade either. This is all about just straight firepower for them.
And they just completely killed Cajun in outside that B bomb site. That looked scary for a moment because if Kerrigan had gone down next then, they would have been able to run straight in. MSL shutting down Zipmix as well. Gonna have to be Device showing up. It looked like there's no head armor there on MSL. That's the difference. Maybe because they've been so effective, they would have wished they had bolt armor here because that could have made a difference now in a 3-on-3.
Especially when you have to get up close versus the SMGs. Kevlar makes all the difference in the world due to the aim punch. And now, while Device, he just needs to be patient, steps out, instant headshot onto Tenski. That was brilliant. That bomb is going to be making its way out, and Device just holds his own, completely shuts down the push onto the A side. One duel after another, he's winning them all, and Rubino's now the last man alive here for Dignitas, hoping to get lucky. But Device is just not giving him a target. 45 seconds left, and this is perfect, right? Device just, Kerrigan is telling Device, it's all right, I'll be first contact. I'm waiting at truck and CT. So if he comes up short, like, you don't even need to peek short, because if he comes up short, I'm going to catch him. And then as soon as I draw the attention, you can then peek. And that's just good team play coming out there from Astralis to make sure that Rubino couldn't get anything done.
Going to lead into another round here with Dignitas because they haven't been able to get the bomb down. They really can't afford anything. So just a couple of upgraded pistols, but it should tie the scoreline here. Astralis, very routine team, shouldn't be giving away around like this. Kerrigan playing close to the smoke in the middle, right in front of MSL, who's trying to sneak through. So a bit of just some weird Counter-Strike coming up here. Shooting through the smoke, not really sure what you're shooting at.
Just awkward, right?
Yeah, awkward Counter-Strike.
This is where you wish you were like Predator or something with the infrared vision.
Alien versus Predator, such a good game.
Oh!
Okay. Collateral damage in the background there. Kirby didn't even want to be part of that fight. Just accidentally stood in the wrong spot. Kerrigan showing up with another SMG, so a lot of money is being made here from the Astralis team. Again, the kill bonus just a little bit bigger on a gun like that. So Dupree with three and Kerrigan. I think it's good that Dupree got that triple because he's been a little bit low on the scoreboard. I think it's going to help him out to just feel like he's part of the game as well.
And that is something that Dupree has been working on since like the dawn of time. He needs strong starts on the maps. If he gets a strong start, he can take off and just becomes this monster that controls everything. But if he gets a slow start, for a while, he had this tendency to just, you know, tab his scoreboard and constantly look at the scoreboard, constantly look at his score, and just, you know, he'd kick himself and he would never be able to get his game going because of it. To the point where I was like, I'm going to take the tab key or like the whatever the key is above caps lock, right? Take that off of your keyboard so you can't actually check anymore.
Look at this early start here favoring Dignitas. Oh, sorry, favoring Dignitas a little bit. Trading 2-for-1, Cajun and Tenski going down. They were trying to go for a boost Astralis in the vents there, and they got caught in the middle of it. So that's obviously very frustrating. We'll see if they could somehow make their way back here. They've got the AWP still on Device, and he's holding A alone, which gives them a bit of presence on B. I think this is sort of the smartest choice that they could have made in terms of stacking a bomb site, but with that kill, Config opening up as they try and counter boost Dupree into the vents and Sip alone. And he has been pretty good in clutches, but this would be quite a different matter. They are sort of rotating the artillery in on Device there, but I think he's going to be too late to the party. Are they going to have another smoke for the cross here? It seems like they will. They know that Sip is down here as well. There's the smoke going up. Device is upstairs, and he's actually going to get a kill on Rubino. Gives them a slight chance, but still they're a man down. The ball is going to be planted again for checkers. Man, this is a tough call.
Completely, well, irrelevant incendiary thrown out there, unfortunately, for Device. He was just trying to throw it out to see if he can actually slow them down from getting in there. Oh! Came so close.
The decal looked like it was right on. I have no idea how that shot didn't go through. Sip looking for an opening as well and doing a lot of damage to Config. Is it really not over yet? It should be. Config out in the open, afraid of getting wallbanged, I think. Just standing in the middle of nowhere, and Sip going to take him down. Rotating, goes for the spray, but he can't get it. And Kierby going to be taking down Device, and it ends up with a double kill for Config at the end of that round. So doing a pretty good job still. 10-9, and Dignitas maintain the round lead here for just a little while longer.
What is the decision taken by Device? He goes for it. Forced by Well, Force Buy coming in from Astralis. You guys will see that in a moment.
Oh, ah, it man. Is just next to him.
Just next to him. That's so frustrating. That would have been sick. It would have made all of the difference as well had they been able to pick up that kill going into the retake. But Dignitas, full buy across the board for them. Just a bit of a patchy buy coming in here for Astralis. And again, just early aggression coming out in MSL. He's hitting all of these key shots for Dignitas. Takes out Kerrigan to start.
He was so quick to Kerrigan. You could tell behind that box, he just wasn't ready for it. Device, on the other hand, is. If you try and go into those vents, you will be showing just the top of your head there. It's not an easy shot to hit for Device, but it's definitely doable. Flick not going to connect. And yeah, if he re-peaked that, there'd be three people waiting for him. So better to just fall back and give a bit of mid control to Dignitas.
This is going to be incredibly frustrating for Device. You can be sure that he was shaking his head after that shot because that looked like it was on to me at least. So no joy for Device. And while Astralis, they're down a man and low on the nades as well. So Dignitas, all they have to do is take their time, pace themselves, and group up. They have all the incendiaries that they need, the Molotovs. They have a couple of smokes as well to work with, and it does look like B-side is where they're going to go. 50 seconds left on this clock, and Dignitas continue to gather up. MSL has cleared out the halls. They're going through checkered, and now the push begins here. Astralis, two players, Cajun and Dupree. It's their time to shine.
They don't have a lot to do with UMP. One guy hiding in the smoke. He can't even help out right now. Dupree alone is going to be going down. Cajun, quick burst to take down MSL, but they know he's there. He gets another one in there, looking for the triple. He's going to get all three. Brave effort being put up by Cajun, but it's just not enough. It will be Dignitas making it 11-9, and that kills Astralis' economy as well. Dignitas, they're really doing a good job, and this is what I was a bit worried about is the CT setup for Astralis. It's just not always that good on this map.
I'm glad to see that Cajun, though, is able to shine a little bit, considering he had such a rough first half, losing so many duels over in B halls to MSL. Now at least he has a little bit of a moment to give himself, you know, some confidence going into the rest of this. It is going to be a hard eco coming in here for Astralis, but you know, they lose three rounds, they should be able to get a buy going on in the next one. And Dignitas, again, this is just not them not showing any respect. They know the state of the economy here for Astralis. They know that they're broke, and so they're just going to power through on this A site. Stack, they don't care. They walk right through it. MSL gets two kills, barely survives, but it doesn't matter in the end. Dupree is going to be moving up on short. Nobody there to greet him, but as soon as he comes around this box, should be a firing squad ready and waiting for him.
There we go.
Or just config.
Execution style instead. I mean, that last round with Dupree hiding in the corner behind that box on the sort of far right side of the bomb site, and then Cajun hiding in the smoke. You got to wonder, what is the setup? Like, what are they going for? What's the call? What's the communication between those two players? Because as soon as Dupree walks out to start shooting, what's Cajun's role in that play? You know, I'm hiding in the smoke. So when you engage them, I'll just still be hiding in the smoke. There's no kind of backup of any kind, you know. It would have made more sense at that point for Cajun to say, I'll underhand flash my way through, and then we both peek at the same time. I mean, anything but that, I guess.
Well, I thought in my mind what was going to happen, given Cajun was that headshot, was that Dupree was going to peek. And while Dupree is just spraying, I'm just blown away that Cajun doesn't spray through the smoke. Yeah, is Dupree communicating to Cajun that there are two guys like dead ahead of Cajun? If Cajun holds down mouse one, between the two of them, they probably spray down both of those guys. So definitely a little bit surprising there. But that's what happens sometimes with Astralis. When the pressure mounts, sometimes it just doesn't quite click. Either the communication comes through and they aren't really communicating effectively to each other the information that's going to keep them alive in these rounds.
Yeah.
Or it turns into that where it's just like a bait fest, where it's like one guy tries to stand out or one guy just gets left out to dry by his teammates. And it just turns into a series of duels. Yeah, Cajun got three kills after that. And it's like, woo. But it could have been a completely different situation had he actually played with his teammate instead of, you know, left them out there. A little bit disappointing, honestly.
We do have a tactical timeout in place right now to see if it's going to make any kind of a difference. You always wonder about doing tactical timeouts into potential ecos. But we'll see if it's going to be playing out well for Astralis right now. It's looking like Dignitas are slightly running away with this game here. Their T side is on point. They're getting a lot of the really good entries, and it's not like Astralis have a lot of mid control either. We were sort of, or I was criticizing Dignitas a bit for this, but Astralis aren't doing it too much either.
Well, both teams seem to be focusing on the sites, and this may be off. I mean, this is where the mind games start to come in between Kerrigan and MSL. They've both done their homework on this map. You can be sure, watch each other's demos, etc., to try and figure out the tendencies, you know, going into that T side. So both of them might be playing off of the fact that, okay, recently we've seen them, you know, not focus so much on mid, go for more of like the straight A plays, the straight B plays. And so this might be what's going into it, where it turns into like a bit of a guessing game with Astralis. You know, where do we stack? Where do we set up? Although, as I say that, now they decide to put the aggression on. Now they decide to just come in and completely take over mid early on. Three players into mid very early there for Astralis, and now two of them are going to remain. It's Cajun and Kerrigan just chilling out with Zipnix on short. So they're waiting for Dignitas to try and go for a split.
22nd round coming up now. After a tactical timeout, and they did have enough money just to go for a buy here, and you can tell it's not a lot that they had. Almost no grenades left, no AWP, obviously. A couple of defuse kits in the pocket there, but it is a little bit risky right now, Astralis, and they're not making any kind of aggressive plays here. Don't really know what's going on. They've got a bit of mid control, and they do at least have a boost going on in vent and by the headshot box in the middle there, Kerrigan. So slight more mid control than they had the previous couple of rounds. Dignitas, on the other hand, could be setting up for an A play.
Yeah, they are definitely going to be going for it here. MSL is dancing on the edge. He will take the fight with Device. Long spray from Device. Half of the bullets going into that the pickup truck, whatever the hell it is. Forklift. And well, nice flash actually forces Zipnix back. He gets nothing done. Kerrigan only able to trade one for one, and that's not good enough. Cajun and Dupree. Cajun is able to rotate over very quickly. He's on short, but the smoke is still blocking him off, and a second smoke gets set up. Dignitas, they're really doing a good job of controlling the space. That allows them to get the plant. Cajun, once again, not going to be able to win his duel. And that leaves it all on Dupree here in a 1v3. He seems to know that there is one. Obviously, he knows that there's one on the left side of A main, but where are the other two players? He sees Squeak door open, so that can mean somebody's waiting for him in there. And had he won that duel, he might have had a chance, but now he's just going to get sandwiched here by all three members of Dignitas. Or he's just going to wreck two of them. He could go for the jump shot, and he's not going to get it. Tenski shuts them down.
A bit of a scary moment there for Dignitas, because they were thinking the same thing. I think you were. Well, you know, he's trapped there. Let's just sandwich him in. We'll kill him quick, and he almost wins that 1v3. So a little bit worrying. But it does work out. He has five bullets left here, so he used the last five bullets to kill Rubino, and then if he had another 10, that could have been a more interesting fight versus Tenski, but he managed to get the jump shot off, and that's going to make it 13-9. Another three rounds here, and Dignitas is going to end up defeating Astralis in the winner's match, which would be a very interesting result, both for the bracket and also just for the sort of the almost legendary streak that Astralis are on in winning group stage games. They've been so, so good at it. Dignitas have been close before, but maybe it's their time to actually shine here. They're playing a good tournament already.
Oh, they're looking very good. I mean, what they did to Nip, it might still be having nightmares about that. And there's the opening shot. Config with the lurk, picks off the second man, that's Dupree, with a delayed peek into A main. He gets caught. Well, Kerrigan's here with the Deagle, but he is looking for that headshot. Still able to put some damage in there, and he will eventually take down Tenski. So nice work from Kerrigan. But it's not a whole lot to go off of, especially now that Cajun B dies again. Cajun, man, he is just struggling right now. Having a real rough time. Nice shot from Tenski called out, of course. But in the end, it is 14-9. And Astralis, well, they went for the round of eco. And having lost so many rounds in a row at this point, five rounds, they're going to have that full buy. This is it. There's no more ground to give. They have to lock it down here. And this is their answer, Anders. You know, they want to go for the double AWP. Yeah. Put Cajun over in the B halls, perhaps, and Device in mid.
Well,
play off of this.
Look at what Dignitas is doing, though. They're going very, very fast towards B. If Cajun doesn't hit a shot immediately, then he is going to be gone. They're just going to rush him down. He has essentially one chance here, and he misses it. And now they're going to try and charge him in. Dupree, same fate for him. Rubino running him down with the AK. And, well, Cajun, he gets one kill, but it's just not enough here. What a great call coming out of Dignitas. They must have guessed that Astralis might have gone for this kind of setup, and it is a really powerful response to just try and see if you can run down that AWP in checkered, and that's exactly what they did. Four versus three, bomb is down as well, and Astralis might as well try and play for overtime. Retaking at this point is going to be so hard.
Yeah, it demands a mistake on Dignitas's part, basically, for Astralis to actually pull this off. The incendiary going in, I mean, this is just Kerrigan trying to check the boxes. Unfortunately for him, MSL is in checkered, and Kerrigan will hit the headshot, blind as well. Zipnix comes through, takes out Tenski. And, oh, he even gets the headshot through the smoke. Lucky headshot gives away the position. And now it's all on Rubino. Wins it 1v1 now versus Zipnix. And the time is ticking. There's not a lot of time here for Zipnix to get this defuse. And Rubino's not even going to give him the chance. The full ace clutch coming in for Dignitas. And Rubino just coming in big. He was lagging behind. But that is a huge round. That basically wraps it up here. Astralis now, what are they going to do next?
A great switch of targets in the middle of all of that, because if he just realized that the guy in the back is not going to be able to shoot me anyway. Got to take care of this first, and That's going to be match and map point here for Dignitas. Astralis almost making that quite unlikely retake work, but just not enough at the end. And the dink through the smoke was enough that Sip knew. Wait a minute. There's something, someone in that smoke. Because if he doesn't get the headshot, he probably just stops shooting then.
Exactly. He's pulling off already, but that dink, he's just like, wait a second, and just goes back and sprays a little bit more. If he doesn't get the dink there, Zipnix gets shot in the back when he tries to go up to the site. That's really, I mean, well, it kind of went Astralis' way, but Rubino just did not allow it to play out that way. Takes control, gets the ace. Well, now Astralis forced by for them. SMG, I mean, again, Device has to go for the UMP. Just to afford to get a, just to get some more nades in the game for themselves here because they're so light on utility. Minute left, and while the push looks like it's going to come through here for Dignitas onto the A side, Bomb is here, and they just go cascading onto the site. Kerrigan boosted up on the box. It's a little bit of an off angle, and he's here to support Zipnix as well, so this could get nasty. One for one trade, and Kerrigan, he gets two kills, two headshots, and he's going to step out for more, but he's going to get shut down by Rubino, and now it's a 2-on-3 retake coming in here for Astralis.
Such good position for Kerrigan, and there's still not enough Cajun and Dupree. I'm going to try and see if they can make this work and extend the series just a little bit longer. He thought maybe check that corner. Got to be careful. Rubino goes down, but it's all on Cajun. He's got almost no health left. Kirby currently with a triple kill. Tensky hiding inside the bomb. And Kirby just running to the B bomb site with the bomb. And Cajun, if he makes any kind of noise right now, it's probably all going to be over. He will find, well, the angle, but not the kill. Tensky going to take him out. And it will be 16-9 favoring Dignitas. Look at that celebration. Big, big result here for what is undoubtedly the second best team in Denmark, but they've had a lot of trouble defeating Astralis for a long time.
It's been the eternal struggle, man.